right, guys. I don't know if you know that many YouTubers or I don't know if you guys watch or anything, but I just watched a video by Pretty Boy Fredo, and it was pretty much a social experiment when he put two young boys of different races and put them out holding a sign saying, please help me, I'm hungry, something like that. I didn't read the sign. And when he put a black boy out there, people just kept ignoring him and stuff. He was out there for an hour and everybody ignored him. But when a Hispanic boy went out, the first second he's still out there, a guy gave him a tray of a quesadilla in it, and another guy gave him $20. I didn't finish watching the video. I was just thinking about something, and I was like, I need to make a video. This kind of, you can consider it a Brotherhood Part 2, because I don't know what a video I'm going to make right now. I don't know what kind of business it's going to be. I'm kind of driving to the park. I don't really have any excuse to go out. But you guys remember Streak 4, Day 45? I think it was. I went to the same park. Now, I went to this park multiple times because my niece was here and I took her to the park during the summer. I went to this park on Day 45. It's because I wanted to go out. It was a nice day and I want to talk to you guys. And I'm glad it's the same park. So I might cut this video when I get there and like start recording while walking with my headphones on. But it's just, I'm trying to like, it's gonna be like a NoFap, but also a positivity video, like a take on our society. As a society, right, we all bleed the same blood, no matter, like, it's not about blood type, it's about color, right? We all bleed red blood, right? We all bleed red, right? We all bleed the same blood. And, we're all, no matter what country you're from, no matter what nationality you are, we're all humans, we're all the same, right? And, we shouldn't be judging each other by, what race we are, what religion we follow, what nationality, what sexuality. We shouldn't judge each other based on what we are. We're all the same people inside. We all have hearts. We all have brains. We're all the same. And that video, kind of maybe think a little bit, of how, good I have it, how good we have it in life, we have problems every day, right? Negativity in school or work or just in general, things affect us every day, right? I'm not denying that we all have bad days, but I just sat down and thought, right? Because that video I saw reminded me of another video I saw of, it was a homeless guy, and it was another social experiment with another kid who wasn't homeless but had a sign next to him just to see who would help the kid over the guy, right? It was a U.S. vet, a retired vet. And, everybody pretty much disrespected the vet and then threw food at him and stuff, but the vet still took whatever money he had, that he had in general, not just that day, because he didn't get anything that day. He took that money and bought the boy that was next to him a slice of pizza. Bought him a slice of pizza, then by himself, he bought the boy. And, it made me think, how good I have in life. I have a good life. I had a good childhood. I grew up with all these video games and toys and, I'm not saying I could get every single video game I wanted. It's that, I had video games in my life. I had TV, I had a good family. I had a mom and dad. I had siblings. I had, know, cousins, aunts, uncles. I had, you know, a good family. And, you know, to this day, I have a good life, you know. Even though, you know, sometimes it's hard in life, you know, with work and stuff, you know, I still have a job, you know. I still have a family, you know. You know, God allowed me to, you know, have all my immediate family with me. Well, in, with me, meaning in life, not like here, because they're in New Jersey. My mom is here. You know, I have a house. I have a roof over my head. I have a phone. I have TVs. I have internet. I have video games. I have a bunch of clothes. I have food every night. I have, you know, a car. I have a job to make money. I have all this stuff, right? I'm good in life. You know, I've learned to like not be so selfish. I learned to not be, you know, want this. I'm not getting this, I'm not getting that. Like, I've learned to be happy with what I have, right? Because there's people out there who don't have what we have. You know, we're fortunate enough. God, you know, helped us live the life that we have now. And, you know, I'm just thankful for, you know, what I have. It could be worse, you know. I could be, you might not even know me. I could be on the streets, you know, God forbid in the future, but I could be in the streets just, you know, homeless. But I have a house, you know, like, I have a good life right now. And not everybody can see that. And you know, I gotta thank God for that, you know, cause I don't know. And that's what I want to say about that topic. But back on the subject of social society. You know, I find it funny. Let me run a little bit. Pull that back. I love how people, right? I see it on YouTube, like, all these comments, right? Not on, like, specifically my channel, but on, like, you know, other channels, right? Especially NoFap channels. People in our society today feel like they're better than everybody else. Like, all this negativity and stuff in social media and the comments. Like, social media has brought us to where we think we're better than everybody. Like, if you have a lot more followers, a lot more, you know, subscribers than somebody else, you're automatically better than them, you know? And, you know, I just feel like, you know, why we bring each other down, you know? As a society, we should be bringing each other up. And, you guys know, in my Brotherhood video, my original Brotherhood video, you know, I talked about just, you know, NoFap, the NoFap community as a whole. And, you know, after I relapsed, like, around that time, I forgot which streak that was when I made that video, but, you know, I feel like going out and walking around. I might do it in a second. But, I'm debating where to, like, go out and walk now, or just, like, finish what I'm saying and then walk. But I definitely want to walk around like that. I'm gonna sit at that spot over there. You guys remember streak 4, day 45. If you didn't see it, go back to it, and you'll see that I sat in that spot right there and talked to you guys. In the same white shirt, too. Well, not the same exact white shirt. I have a bunch of white shirts, you know, bunches come in, like, different packs and stuff, but, you know, like, as I said, you know, I made the Brotherhood video, you know, because I noticed the NoFap community, like, on Reddit and on the website, like, they're supportive, you know, support each other. Whenever we last bring ourselves back, we bring each other back up, You know, we help each other with urges. We just help each other, like, you know, get better in life. You give each other advice. You give each other different stuff. And, I don't know, I just, you know, I look on, like, not only say everybody, but like some people. I looked on some of the, you know, YouTube channels, the NoFap YouTube channels, like about a month ago, right? You know, when people relapse, right? For example, like 24/7 betterment. I can't even speak his name. 24/7 betterment. You know, now he's on day 44, and I'm proud of you for that, man. I put a comment on your video this morning, but I had to go. My mom had some more friends to pick up, so I had to go get up and, you know, go. But I saw your video. You're on day 44. You're 2 days ahead of me. And I'm proud of you, man. I had to bring you this video because, you know, it's the example of a video that I saw people commented on. You know, he relapsed, you know, and, you know, of course there were some comments that supported him and stuff, you know, then I saw the dislikes, and I was like, yo, why there's so many dislikes in this video? And, you know, and I saw comments, right? There's comments that are, like, doubting him and, you know, just giving him a hard time for, like, no reason, man. I'm like, yo. I think he talked about it. He did this experiment, right? He made a video saying he relapsed just to see the negativity, and there was negativity in that video. Then he made another video, you know, saying, you know, got you, I didn't relapse, I just wanted to see, like, what you guys were saying and stuff. You know, those people hate on him, and, you know, just all the dislikes, you know, just people bring him down about relapse. You know, when somebody relapses, you're supposed to bring him up, you're supposed to, and, you know, motivate them, you're supposed to say, all right, you do better this time. But, you know, you just, you know, people say, you know, you're not supposed to, you know, feel, you're supposed to beat yourself over a relapse, because, you know, relapses are supposed to happen, you know. It's just a hard, addictions are hard to break, you know, especially something so easy like fapping. Like fapping, it's available 24/7, you know. You don't even need anything, you just need your hands, right? That's all you need, honestly. And with the world we live in now, where 13-year-old girls are posting music leads, you know, with short shorts on and, like, you know, looking like 18-year-old girls, but they're 13, you know, and all these girls just showing themselves all over the place, you know, urges. Let me try to get my seatbelt. You know, urges are everywhere, and you know, it's hard nowadays. You know, back in the day, there was no internet, there was no, there was TV, but then TV didn't show stuff like that. It showed, like, the news and a few shows, and then when you wanted to go see a movie, you had to go to a movie theater. You know, it wasn't, well, pretty much what I'm saying, it wasn't accessible. You know, porn, like porn stuff like that, weren't as accessible, and women back then were classy, so they wouldn't dress, you know, like, you know how girls dress now. And, you know, it just, you know, I'm gonna get out and walk. Let's walk into something. Like, talk to you guys.
All right, guys, hopefully you can see me. I have, like, fingerprints on my screen, so I can't tell if you can see me or not, but I just parked over there and now I'm walking. Hopefully, I don't see anybody from my school. Well, my school's, like, right over there. The park is, like, next to elementary school. My school is, like, next to the park. So, yeah, as I was saying, like, you know, with the world we live in, there's urges, like, everywhere. You know, you can't stop yourself, right? There's urges. And, you know, as a no-fapper, you have to, you know, fight. The fight all of it. And no, honestly, I thought there was someone, like, standing right there, but it's just a pole. I'm coming here. I don't know if you guys remember this. This isn't the exact This isn't the exact place I stood at, but you know, it was close. You know, as a brotherhood, sorry for the wind. I just realized it's windy and affecting the microphone, but I'm gonna sit down a second. Sit down like right here. Now, I remember you guys saying you're tired of, you know, me sitting in the car and talking to you guys. And, you know, there wasn't really anything I could do about it, but, you know, I decided to come out to the park. I was saying, as a NoFapper, you know, you have to, you know, fight through the urges. You have to learn to, like, fight your brain pretty much and, you know, just fight through these urges. And if you got any advice on that, you can check out. I'll post a link in the description. I posted a video back in Street 4 when I was close to 90 days called How I Deal with Urges. And yeah, back in my pre-Florida high school days. Reason I'm looking back is because people back there, myself here, it's like, they can't hear me. Yes, you can check that video if you want. You know, it'll help you guys out. But, you know, there's sometimes when, you know, you can't, you know, there's some urges we just can't fight. You know, sometimes we just give in because, you know, it's a hard addiction, like I said. You know, sometimes we give in. And, you know, as a brotherhood, you know, we're supposed to pick each other back up, you know, give each other support and say, all right, you got this time. You know, just remember, you know, I say every time you guys relapse, I post in the comment section, I would say, you know, just, you know, pick yourself back up and, you know, just get back on the wagon. I always tell you guys, get back on the wagon. You know, just learn why you relapse. So that next time, you know, the same urge comes up, you know how you felt after you relapsed, and then you just keep going, you know, keep going strong. And yeah, but you know, sometimes, you know, it's too much for us, and we give in, relapse, right? And you know, as a brotherhood, I keep repeating myself, but as a brotherhood, we're supposed to, you know, pick each other up, you know, like your actual blood brother, you know. Even though you two like might argue and fight once in a while, you know your brothers. You know, when one of you is down, you know, you say like, all right, you know, stop being pity, stop pitying yourself, you know, pick yourself back up and get back on the wagon. You know, you can get through this. You know, it's supposed to help each other out, you know. And that's when I see the negativity on YouTube comment section. That, you know, it's like, come on, guys. Like, how would you feel, right? Because, like, apparently the negative NoFap people are, like, they're the best NoFappers. Like, you can get 9 days, no problem. You know, what if you relapse and then somebody else, you know, said, oh, you suck. Oh, you never get to 90 days. You know, why even trying? And so, how would you feel? You know, how would you feel if someone said that to you after you relapse? You know, would you like that, or would you like somebody to be like, all right, man, you relapsed, but you know, just remember why you did it. You know, remember why you're doing NoFap. You know, you aren't trying to be your best self. You know, pick yourself back up. You're gonna get this, man. This time you're gonna be a lot better. You know, what would you like to hear that instead? Because I know I would. And you know, that's why we disappoint her, you know, because, you know, we it's already bad when one of us, you know, relapses. You know, it hurts when I see in the comment section, I see in other YouTube, NoFap YouTubers, videos that they relapse. You know, it hurts. You know, it hurts me because, you know, every NoFapper is my brother, right? We're all brothers. And, you know, when somebody relapses, it hurts me. I'm like, you know, because I know everybody, all of you watching this right now, want to be your best self. And when you relapse, you know, you push yourself back. So that's why it hurts. And it reminds me of one time when I got to a good streak. I think it was like my early YouTube days, so NoFap. I was doing good in the streak, and then I relapsed, and I felt like terrible about it. You know, I was one of my worst relapses, and you know, Somi sent me a video. You know, sent me a video, not text. He sent me a video. You know, saying that he felt that. You know, he feels me because he knows I want this. He knows I want to get to 9 days, and then he just, you know, it's hard. You know, that he said he feels me because, you know, as brothers, you feel each other's pain. So he was like, you know, just get back in the wagon. You know, you're gonna do better this time. And you know, eventually I got to 9 days. You know, with that support. And yeah, that's why I made the Brotherhood video. The Brotherhood, you know, even though I made a Brotherhood video, I ain't going into too much detail what the Brotherhood is, what I meant about it. So I guess I'm going to detail now. You know, NoFap Brotherhood, you know, we help each other out. And that's what we do in this NoFap channel. You know, once in a while I get, you know, negative comments, and you know, most of the time that only happened like once or twice. You know, once in a while I'll get them, and then, you know, I just either ignore them or just, you know, I don't think I deleted. I think I deleted one comment because this person was like being like super negative, and you know, I would keep saying positive and motivating. Even though sometimes I put some negativity at the end of my videos. Well, for the past like in 2 weeks ago or like last week, most of my videos were negative before I started bringing positivity back into it. And you know, yeah, I said, you know, sometimes it's some negative people, some negative NoFappers, but you know, just have to ignore it. You know, you can't feed into negativity. You know, you just have to shoot out. Until we got to the past couple of days, you just have to shoot out positivity. No matter how much negativity somebody brings to you, you have to shoot out nothing but positivity. And it's not even the word alliterate, reiterate into you know, you guys' minds. You know, when somebody's negative in your life, somebody's like messing you, bullying you, you know, just wish them good luck in their life and just move on. You know, just keep your space. You know, when they come up to you, just shoot nothing but positivity. You know, just throw out nothing but positivity in your life. When you send out nothing but positivity, no negative people come in your life. Only positive people come in your life because they feel your positive energy and they come to you. You attract positive people. And yeah, that's what I do. That's what I started doing. You know, I told my mom that too because she was being negative one time. I was like, Mom, you know, no matter how negative somebody's being to you, just shoot out positivity, you know. And if you guys remember earlier this week, I had like positive days, you know, because I think it was like two or three positive days in a row. And that's because, you know, I was shooting the positivity. You know, that week I was shooting nothing positivity. Whenever somebody negative, I shoot positivity. Like, you know, with Snapchat girl, you know, she's just being petty and positive and negative, but, you know, I just shoot, you know, positivity. And, you know, that's whatever works out, works out. If, you know, if she's continued to be negative or and petty like she was before, you know, I have to keep my space. You know, once in a while I say hi to her and stuff, but, you know, I just keep my space. And, that's what I told you guys to do. You know, just be positive. You know, no matter what bad days you're having and stuff, you just always want to have positive aura at all times. Pretty much all I'm saying. I'm just rambling at this point. Like, keep positive aura at all times. That's how you attract positive people in your life. And you know, you find a positive girl one day. You know, you go confident to a mall or something, or a party, or some event. You know, what that has to do with your interest, like for example me, a car show or a game tournament or a game something, and you know, you see a girl there and you find attractive and you go talk to her and you talk to her about, you know, stuff that's there, and you know, shooting you're being fun, you're being confident, you being entertaining, being funny, and you're being positive. You know, as Corey Wayne said, whenever you interact with a girl, you always want the interaction to be positive. You want her to think that you're a positive person. You want her to know that you're a positive person. You know, just always be positive. And when she sees that, she'll see you as a fun, confident, positive person, and she always want to hang out with you. And then when you move on from that, you go on dates, you go on, you know, hang out, have fun, hook up, you know, repeat, recycle, rinse, repeat. And eventually she wanted to be in a relationship with you, and then you go on from there. So, you know, just always stay positive, you know. That's what I want this. That's pretty much what I want this video to be about. You know, I'm gonna call it Brotherhood Part 2 or something. And you know, this is something, you know, Pretty Boy Fredo, you know, brought up with his video. Because Pretty Boy Fredo uploads some good videos, like some really motivating videos. This man's amazing. If you haven't checked out his channel, go check it out. And when I go home, I'm going to watch the video that Evan posted yesterday in the comments. And he said, check out the Great Porn Experiment. And, you know, I put it in my history, so, you know, I wouldn't forget it. It's my history. I'm going to go home and watch it. And that's a great Gatsby car. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's like a convertible, like, you know how Gatsby had a yellow, like, 1920s car? That was like a blue 1920s car, so that's cool. But yeah, I'm gonna watch it when I get home. This is good, just look good video, 29 minutes. I heard about it before, I heard about it multiple times actually, but I never actually like sat down and watched it. You know, if you guys have any other suggestions or videos that you want me to see or want anywhere else to see, you know, just post in the comment section, you know, I'll be sure to watch it. You know, Evan also told me to check out a YouTube channel. I gotta check that channel out after I watch the Great Porn Experiment TED Talks. And, but yeah, if you have any videos or anything or any articles, anything you want me to check out, just post it down below. I'll 100% check it out. You know, don't be afraid. Yeah, if you want anyone to watch it too, just put it down there. You know, on. We'll check it out. Also, somebody commented one day and asked if there's some way that he can contact me, you know, about like NoFap problems he was having and stuff. You know, and I sat there. I was gonna put my Twitter, but then I realized I'm not using social media until like I reach 60 days or so. I'm not getting back to social media until I reach 60 days. And yeah, I was sitting there, I was like, huh. And then I realized I use Telegram. You know, you guys probably never heard of Telegram. It's like a messenger. It's like Facebook Messenger or Skype, but it's like, you know, Telegram. And that Reddit and YouTube are the only social media apps I use. Facebook Messenger sometimes, whenever my brother or someone else, one of my friends send me something, I'll go on there and check it out. But those are the only apps I use. And Telegram, I use strictly for NoFap, like the NoFap group and stuff. Those are on Telegram. You know, I go in there to check on, to talk to Somi and everybody else in the group chat. So, you know, if you want to talk to me about NoFap or anything in your life, just anything in general, you know, you can contact me on there, you know, download Telegram. It's also on the computer. You don't have to download the app or anything. Just go on the website, you know, sign up, and then, you know, just log in. And then, you know, add me, you know, at Hacker Life. You know, you guys know how to spell Hacker Life. I'm going to put it in the video, but you guys know how to spell it. You know, no space, no underscore or anything. Just Hacker Life. You know, right now I have the Super Saiyan Goku profile picture on there because now that I said 30 days is Super Saiyan, 6 days Super Saiyan Blue, and 9 days Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken. So, you know, just feel free to message me on there. And I was on like ASAP because whenever I get a notification from Telegram, I always like instantly go on there. That's my class. But I always go on there and I talk to somebody on there because usually somebody has urges or they need that voice or something, you know, and so I'm on there to help. So as soon as you mess me on there, I'll respond to it. You know, I'm like that. You know, I'm basically on 24/7 except I sleep. So that's like the only reason why I'm not on there like 24/7. But as I said, that's pretty much all I want to talk about. You know, this society and the brotherhood in general. You know, just this negative people. You know. We gotta do better as a society, pretty much. You know, as a brotherhood, NoFap brotherhood, we gotta do better. You know, there's like, you know, for the most part, the brotherhood, you know, it's full of positive people. Full of positive people. You know, guys are on here once in a while, you know, helping each other out. You know, I see you guys in the comment section. That's how me out. I help you guys out. You know, and the other NoFap YouTubers, you know. Carnegie and Lindsay, 24/7 Betterman, I keep messing up your name, Flocka TV, even though he's over 9 days right now, he's over 100 days actually. I'm missing a couple. 365 days, NoFap, you know, he doesn't really upload that much anymore. I'm missing some, it's like some I watch like every single day. Anyway, just check out like everybody's channels, and hope you guys understand what I was saying about, you know, society and the brotherhood. For the most part, you know, negative people, we just gotta show all negative people love, you know, because everybody's negative for a reason, right? I mean, there's a few people that are negative for no reason, but. For the most part, everybody's negative for a reason. So this guy, you know, showing nothing but love and positivity, and, you know, wish him luck in life, and, you know, hope that, you know, our positive aura will, you know, like they'll feel that positive aura and be like, you know, why am I angry for? You know, there's so much to life. You know, look at the sunlight. You know, there's so much to life. And guys, just remember. To a certain point, NoFap, you know, when you get to like where I am right now, you know, you just get appreciative of something. Like, you know, I just came to the park and felt like recording because, you know, I just feel good right now. I feel good in life, you know. Yesterday I felt this like bit of energy, you know, because I felt like I know for a fact I want to meet a girl that's right for me, you know, one that's positive, one that's, you know, it's good. I know, like, I just felt energy, like, I don't know, just some energy, like, I felt like I'm gonna be here, like, soon, like, you know, like, you know, it's gonna be weird if, like, you know, in a couple, like, weeks or now, you guys see me a video saying I met a girl today, but, you know, I just have a feeling, you know, it was just a good feeling last night. It was a warm feeling. I was like, I'm gonna meet somebody, you know. And I know I'm gonna meet somebody, but I feel like I'm gonna meet somebody soon, you know? No, it felt good. It's a good feeling. hey guys, just fight the urges, you know? You guys know how bad the urges get. Like, my Apple reveal is like almost every day. You guys know how bad the urges get, but, you know, I fight through the trends, I fight the urges, and, you know, once you fight through them, and, you know, the days get easier, and you're just like, wow. You know, it's a beautiful, my life is pretty beautiful right now. You know, I have everything I need in life. You know, I'm happy. You know, you're just happy. You know, and then the urges come back eventually. But, you know, for a while, you're just happy. You know, that's what NoFap is about. Make your life happy. Make yourself better. You know, make yourself positive. Just clear yourself. You know, spiritually, physically, and emotionally, just clear yourself. Make yourself positive, happy, you know. But also, I just can't, you know, I just can't just be like, I'm happy and stuff, because, you know, I keep my guard up at all times, you know. But even though I can keep my guard up, you know, I'm not gonna stop me from being happy, so not worried about that. But I'm enjoying life, you know. Hope you guys enjoying life too. But hope you guys doing journeys. If we got some the wagon, or it's good, how we make days count, space positive, don't try to get in my heart or twice, or I try to get you the worst, or when you're not prepared. So always keep your guard up. and I'll see you guys. I don't know what that kid was doing, but see you guys here tomorrow or Monday. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And remember, always be happy and positive. Peace.